Now that we have the basic idea of what a circuit is and how it works, it turns out that there are actually two different kinds of circuits. So there are combinational circuits, which are the kind that we're looking at today, where the outputs are purely a Boolean function of their inputs. They're a combination of their inputs. In other words, they're not dependent on time. You give them the same inputs, they will eventually converge to the same outputs. These are most commonly used in computers for doing computation. There is also another kind of circuit called a sequential circuit, where the output is dependent on previous outputs. And so things need to be examined in sequence rather than simply combinationally. And these are time dependent. And these are often used for memory because you have to remember an earlier value. So we'll talk about sequential circuits next time. And today we're going to focus on using combinational circuits for computation. So the goal is to identify some circuits that perform useful computation. So things like testing bits to see if they're equal, or selecting between multiple inputs, adding, subtracting, doing bitwise operations, and then gradually moving up and making them work on larger pieces of data. So obviously there are going to be other useful things, but I just want to show you a few of them. And this will hopefully convince you that we can build up all the things that we need in order to do general purpose computation using just these basic logic gates and putting them into circuits. So here's a circuit that is a bit equality circuit. So this takes two inputs, A and B. And you can see up here that there is an AND gate here that's taking both of those values in as inputs. We have another AND gate down here that's taking the opposite of the inputs. And then we have an OR gate that takes the result of those two ANDs and puts them together for the final result. So if we were to write this in Boolean form, it would look like this. So A equals B equals, or is equivalent to, A and B ORed with not A and not B. And so you can see here that, yeah, this is pretty much the definition of equality, right? So A equals B should be true if they're both true, or if they're both false. Otherwise, they're not equal. So we've essentially encoded those two cases directly in the circuit. And this is now an output signal that is going to be true if these two things are the same, and it is going to be false or off if they're not the same. So here's another interesting one. So this one actually has three inputs. So it has an A and a B input as before, and they're both going to one of these AND gates. And then we have this thing called S that's coming in. We have S getting split here, and one side is going directly into this AND gate with A, and then the other signal from S is going through an inverter and then being combined in an AND with B. Then we have an OR gate to combine the results of the output. So it's worth thinking about this for a second and trying to figure out what this accomplishes. And so maybe it's worth pausing the video and thinking about that. So again, here's the circuit, and the circuit doesn't give us quite as much information in this case. So it's S and A, or not S and B. And if you think about that for a little bit, hopefully what you'll realize is that if S is true, then the final value is going to be A. So basically, if A is set, then this is going to be true if S is 1, right? The opposite is true for B, right? The output is going to be B only if S is false at the beginning, right? Because if S is false, then not S is going to be true, and then the output is going to be whatever the value of B is. So that's why we call this a multiplexer or a selector, because the S input is allowing us to select between A and B. So if it's true, we're going to get A, and if it's false, we're going to get B. Here's an interesting one. So this has an XOR and an AND. So the A and the B go into the XOR, and the output is called S. So this is actually a circuit that has two outputs. So this output is called S, and then A and B also both go into the AND. and the output of that AND is called C. So it's worth pausing here and working out the truth table for this on your own and seeing if you can spot any trends here. Okay, so here's the truth table and here's the formula. So what you'll observe here is that as long as one of these is set, the A and the B, as long as one of them is set, the S bit is going to be set, right? And that's what we get because of XOR, right? Not when they're both set. So only when one of them is set. The C output is only going to be true if both A and B are true. And if you think about this for a second, and you look at the title of the slide, you'll realize what this is doing. This is doing an addition, a one-bit addition. So 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 0 with a 1 carry. And if you write the columns this way, you can see that if you read this as a binary number from left to right, it's a 2. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So this is what's called a half adder, because it does sort of a partial addition. And that's why sometimes we call this the sum and the carry output. And that's why I label them as S and C.